Hello, everyone. So as part of Azure Communication Services, we offer different communication modalities, one of which is chat. So Chat Toolkit is a very easy to use developer toolkit that comes with a set of APIs, SDKs in 5 languages, and a UI library that enables developers to build highly customizable one-on-one and group chat experiences. And as part of that, you can do multiple different features are offered, including like participant management. You can choose to share the history with participants who are being added to a group chat or being removed. You can real life indicators like, you know, when a user is typing or when another user has read your message. So read receipts, you have offline messages. Let's say if the person that you're trying to chat with, they are not active on their app, you can send a message and they'll receive it when they are actually online in the app itself. We also offer push notifications and even detailed analytics on how the chat service in your application is performing. And as briefly talked about before, we are also providing interoperability with Teams. So you can join into Teams meetings and chats as users and be able to talk to Teams user while being in your own custom application, all built on Azure Communication Services.
That's really interesting. Can we see it? Can we try it?
Sure. How about we actually chat over an application right now, which is built using Azure Communication Services?
Yeah, how does that bring your screen?
Awesome. So this is an application that our team has built to sort of demo some of the features that comes with that chat. You can also go ahead and, you know, we'll be able to try it out, but we'll go into that in a bit. First, you and me, Frank, let's try it out. So as you can see, this is a simple click to chat experience. You don't need to download any application. You don't need to go and sign up for anything. You can just click and chat in a web browser. So I'm going to start a chat thread. And as part of it, I will assign name to me, and I love emojis, so I'm going to add an emoji as part of it as well. And I love cats, so my avatar will be cat today. So I'm sending you a link to this one to join in on fun, and I'll see you in the chat window.
Okay, so I will create my... my thing, and I will be a baby kraken.
Yes. Oh, I see you there. So we're already typing messages.
Yeah, I see you there.
See your typing indicator.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. And like, what's that checkbox I have beside like the message I just sent?
Yeah, so that checkbox is actually doing a bunch of different things. It's part of the real-time indicators that we talked about earlier. So as when you were typing, I could see your Frank is typing indicator here. And these are more of like read receipts. So a checkbox means, you know, the message has been sent from my side. An eye icon, which I'm seeing right now, means that you have actually seen my message. So I get like these real-time feedback on, you know, has the person seen? Are they typing? Are they active? Yep. So, you know, it kind of increases your collaboration while you're in chat instead of just waiting and wondering, did that person read my message? Are they going to respond? So increasing your collaboration right there. And if I want, you know, I can send some emojis. As I said, I love emojis. So kind of building up on that experience.
That's really nice. I always wonder, like, when we are in a chat, like, that person is still there? Or I'm waiting for nothing.
Right.
Anxiously
waiting.
Having that is really nice. Okay, they saw my message. Like, they know. They should reply.
Yes.
And then they panic because they don't.
Yep, classic. Yep.
So what else can you do with all that chat?
Yes. Sure. So this application actually does not come with all the feature set that we provide, but it does give you a glimpse into the different things that you can do as part of a chat experience built on ACS. So for example, in this participant list, I can see who all are there. I can invite people to join in. I can even remove you as a participant. So, you know, if you're bothering me or being a noisy chat participant, I'm like, Frank is out. Or if I get too bored, I'm like, okay, I am just going to leave this chat. So you can leave this chat. So, you know, you have the facility to leave the chat, remove other people, add other people as well. Another fun thing right now, for example, I don't like this chat title that we have, Chat with Frank. It's a very, very, very boring. So let's add some fun stuff to this one. And emoji as usual. So you can go and update the topic of the thread, you know, for more serious stuff. It could be like a meeting sync, blah, blah, blah. But because this is a fun demo, so we have fun stuff going on here. And other things, as I said, some things that we don't provide here, but you can actually do is, for example, editing your message after you've sent it, deleting a message, a bunch of different things. You can send file links through it. But as I said before, this is sort of just giving you a tiny glimpse into what a chat experience built on ACES can look like.
Very interesting. And in 1 minute, I see the time flying. How can our audience can try this out?
Yes. So we actually have this sample published on our documentation as well. We provide you a tutorial to actually go and download the code and deploy the app locally, or even go and publish it to Azure. So I'm going to quickly, and we've also documented what the architecture of this looks like. You can find all of it in our Azure documentation that we link later. But this is our GitHub repository under Azure Samples that talks about the web chat hero. I wanted to quickly give you a glimpse of what does it look like to actually start a thread. So let's jump into that as well. So if you look at it here, we have all the code that talks about it. You get a giant chat client. I have a participant who's being added here. So I've created a new user communication user participant. And then it's as easy as just saying create chat thread client with this topic of the thread and with these participants. So just 2-3 lines of codes, and you're actually able to spin up a chat thread exactly as we saw in our application when we were using. So all of this and a lot more wonderful stuff is published on our Azure documentation and in our GitHub samples that you can go and start trying out today.
Wonderful. We'll make sure to make all those links into our show notes. Thank you.
Definitely.